Thank you for sharing from your homes in this Eucharist on Second Sunday of Lent. Our priest celebrant this morning is Father Ephraim Tige with Mark Knapper, our seminarian preaching. Life takes us on many paths, including the mountainous and testing. Abram of old was called to sacrifice his long-awaited and dearly loved son, Isaac. Jesus' mission involved the cross. In the midst of the worst times, the power of God's love shines through. Abraham's obedience brought him a blessed future. Jesus' message of the cross was accompanied by this transfiguration. In the midst of our worst moments, God's power bursts through, so we know we are God's beloved daughters and sons. Let's pause for a moment of silence to gather ourselves and to enter God's presence with open hands and grateful hearts.
Brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have
mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who have commanded us to listen to your beloved Son, be pleased, we pray, to nourish us inwardly by your word, that with spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God tested Abraham. God said to him, Abraham. And Abraham said, Here I am. God said, Take your son, your only son Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah, and offer him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains that I shall show you. When Abraham and Isaac came to the place that God had shown him, Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order. He bound his son Isaac and laid him on the altar on top of the wood. Then Abraham reached out his hand and took the knife to kill his son. But the angel of the Lord called to Abraham from heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he replied, Here I am. The angel said, Do not lay your hand on the boy or do anything to him. For now I know that you fear God, since you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me. Abraham looked up and saw a ram caught in a thicket by its horns. Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up as a burnt offering instead of his son. The angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you, and I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of their enemies, and by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessing for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will call upon your name. presence of all his people. In the courts of his house, in your midst, O Jerusalem, I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own son, but gave him up for all of us, will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? Is it God who justifies? Who is to condemn? Is it Christ Jesus who died? And indeed, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who intercedes for us? Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. He was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no one on earth could bleach them. And there appeared to them Elijah and Moses, who were talking with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Rabbi, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, one for Elijah." Peter did not know what to say, for they were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud there came a voice, "This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him." Suddenly, when they looked around, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they were coming down from the mountain, Jesus ordered them to tell no one about what they'd seen until after the Son of Humanity had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what this rising from the dead could mean. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, welcome to the second Sunday of Lent, where we contemplate Jesus, taking with him Peter, James, and John to go up on a mountain so that he can reveal his transfiguration, to reveal his glory. Today's Gospel teaches us something important about the reality of not only who Jesus really is, but also the reality of suffering. Jesus invited his disciples and take them up the mountain, but reminded them to go down where he will undergo his suffering, his passion, death, and eventually his resurrection. The second Sunday of Lent is the time when we learn about the reality of suffering and about the more significant or more pressing question, where is God in the midst of our suffering? Suffering is a part of life. Every one of us experiences in one way or another a kind or form of suffering, and no one is excused. Some of our experiences of suffering are maybe because of external circumstances which are out of our control. I remember a lot of sufferings I experienced. I suffered bullying when I was in primary, and because of that, I grew up lacking in self-confidence. 1 month after I entered the seminary, I lost my grandmom and was not able to go home to farewell her. In my last year in the seminary, 2 days before my practical exam in hearing confessions, my adopted sister, who is also my cousin, died because of heart failure. And just recently, a week before my 40th birthday, I lost my auntie because of cancer. Though I know that God is always with us amidst life difficulties, but sometimes I feel that when I am in deep anguish and pain, there is this voice that tells me that I am alone. Not only that we question why suffering is happening to us, but there is a voice that constantly echoes that we are alone. But my dear brothers and sisters, that voice is a lie. No one dreams of sorrow or grief, but our hearts resist suffering because we are afraid to be alone. Sufferings caused by external circumstances are painful by themselves, but the storms that happen inside our hearts are sometimes the worst. Our sufferings become unbearable not so much because of the external circumstances, but because of what is going on inside our hearts. The second week of Lent is that moment when we receive encouragement from the Lord to help us realize that we are never alone, and we never have been alone. No matter whether suffering has been because of external circumstances, or because of our own doings, or because of our own sins, even though we have never heard or have never seen him, we were never alone, and we will never be alone. It is our prayer that the transfiguration of the Lord may help us appreciate that it is God's will to give us that courage to face our sufferings, pains, and sorrows by showing to us a glimpse of God's glory. The Lord Jesus is there beside us, empowering us, giving us a glimpse of our own glorifications, our own transfigurations. The second week of Lent is a great reminder to us that life is a series of upward and downward journey. Life is a cycle of pain and joy, sickness and health, tears and laughter. The second week of Lent is important to us because it is personal to us. And there is good news in today's Gospel. And the good news is, we are not alone. And my dear brothers and sisters, we never had to face suffering alone. It would be great to stay on the top of the mountain, but Jesus wants to reveal to us that His glory starts at the bottom of the mountain where life is difficult. And He is going to remind us over and over again that He has been and will always be there for us and with us in the ordeals of our lives. And we will constantly remind us, and He will constantly remind us, that we will never be alone. The Christian's response to another's suffering is not to rejoice in it, even if that person deserves it. It is usually not right to point out to that person that their suffering is just. It is also not usually right to tell another how this ordeal could be good for their character. The proper response to another's suffering is kindness and mercy, so that we lessen that suffering if we can. My dear sisters and brothers, we do not have to bear our sufferings alone. Suffering is unavoidable, but suffering becomes bearable if we are not alone. And the good news is, we are not. We have one another. We have the Lord. With Him, we will not be alone and never have been alone. And so let us pray for the blessing and for the grace to have the faith like Abraham, our faith, our father in faith, to have faith and total confidence in God who is always with us.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, listening to God's word, Abraham believed and followed Him. So too, disciples of Jesus heard the voice of the Father declaring Jesus as His beloved Son. and asking us to listen to him with the same trust. We raise our voices, our prayers to him, our concerns and the concerns of the world.
For the strength we need to embrace the journey of life, holding to the hope that our experiences of the cross will lead us to God's glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through prayer, fasting and helping others, we may grow in the image of Jesus and be instruments of God's presence and action in our world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering from COVID-19 and for countries badly affected, that God will restore the health of the sick and free our world from the pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our young people, that their attitudes and actions may be shaped by the person of Jesus and his gospel of love and respect for human dignity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That peoples living in drought zones in Africa and in war zones from Yemen to Syria may receive the aid they desperately need to rebuild their lives and to live in peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they may be enlightened with wisdom by the one who loves the whole world as they seek solutions to the challenges of today. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may experience the compassion and healing of God through the care they receive from medical personnel and family members. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Imploring God's mercy and his healing. Now I raise a prayer for the people who are infected with COVID-19 or facing quarantine. Jesus, during your ministry on earth, you showed your power and caring by healing people of all ages and stages of life from physical, mental, and spiritual ailments. Be present now to people who need your loving touch because of COVID-19. May they feel your power of healing through the care of doctors and nurses and caregivers. Take away the fear, anxiety, and feelings of isolation from people receiving treatment or under quarantine. Give them a sense of purpose in pursuing health and protecting others from exposure to the disease. Protect their families and friends who love, and give peace to all who care for them. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
You know my resting and my
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of this day, for our good and the good of all souls of Jesus.
May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults, and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after he had told the disciples of his coming death, on the holy mountain he manifested to them his glory, to show, even by the testimony of the law and the prophets, that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." mystery of faith.
When we keep this pledge, this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the sacred passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your beloved church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, Patrick and Michael, our bishops, the honorary bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O Lord Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will.
will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you on this.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Gentle more.
as we receive these glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, O Lord, for allowing us, while still on earth, to be partakers even now of the things of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your head and pray for God's blessing. Bless your faithful, we pray, Lord, with a blessing that endures forever, and keep them faithful to the gospel of your only begotten Son, so that they may always desire and at last attain that glory whose beauty he showed in his own body, to the amazement of his apostles, through Christ our Lord. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.